नई दिल्ली में केंद्रीय वित्त मंत्री निर्मला सीतारमण की अध्यक्षता में बुधवार को जीएसटी काउंसिलिंग की 38वीं मीटिंग का आयोजन किया गया। इस मीटिंग में कई घोषणाएं की गई, जिसमें व्यापारियों के लिए जीएसटी R1 की लेट फीस को माफ कर दिया गया। जो व्यापारी अपनी पिछले रिटर्न्स 10 जनवरी 2020 तक जमा करा देंगे, उनको कोई लेट फीस नहीं लगेगी। उसके बाद एक और महत्वपूर्ण घोषणा के अंतर्गत जीएसटी की वर्ष 2017-2018 की वार्षिक रिटर्न की अवधि 1 माह बढ़ाकर 31 जनवरी 2020 कर दी है। जैसा कि खबरें आ रही थी कि जीएसटी के अंतर्गत कर की दरों को बढ़ाया जा सकता है, इन सभी खबरों को गलत साबित करते हुए कर की दरों में कोई परिवर्तन नहीं किया गया है। सभी प्रदेशों द्वारा चलाए गए लॉटरियों पर जीएसटी का यूनिफॉर्म रेट 28% कर दिया गया है। वुवन व नॉन वुवन बैग्स पर भी कर का यूनिफॉर्म रेट 18% तय कर दिया गया है। इसके अतिरिक्त जीएसटी के तहत इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट की सीमा को एलिजिबल क्रेडिट का 120% की बजाय घटाकर 110% कर दिया गया है। इससे व्यापारियों पर अतिरिक्त बोझ पड़ेगा।
हरिजन, कल जो मीटिंग हुई है उसमें व्यापारियों के लिए क्या घोषणा है, उनके बारे में जानकारी दी थी?
जीएसटी काउंसिल की 38वीं मीटिंग, जिसे कि निर्मला सीतारमण जी केंद्रीय वित्त मंत्री मैडम ने चेयर किया था, उसमें व्यापारियों के लिए बहुत सारी घोषणाएं की गई हैं, जिसमें मुख्यतः व्यापारियों को एक बड़ी रियायत दी गई है। जो व्यापारियों का एक GSTR1 की रिटर्न होती है, मंथली रिटर्न फाइल करनी होती है, जिसमें उनको डिटेल में सारे बिल की डिटेल्स देनी होती हैं, वो रिटर्न जिनकी भी पेंडिंग थी, अगर वो व्यापारी उसे 10 जनवरी 2020 तक पूरा कर देते हैं तो उन पे कोई भी पेनल्टी नहीं लगाई जाएगी। वो ये स्कीम 2 जुलाई 2017 से अब तक पेंडिंग रिटर्नों पर लागू होगी, जिससे कि व्यापारी वर्ग को बहुत बड़ी रियायत मिलेगी। दूसरा एक मुख्यतः घोषणा एक और की गई है कि GSTR 9 और 9C, जो कि GST की वार्षिक रिटर्न है, उसमें 1 महीने की अवधि और बढ़ा दी गई है। पहले इसकी लास्ट डेट 31 दिसंबर 2019 थी, जिसको की बढ़ाकर 31 जनवरी 2020 कर दिया गया है। और इस कल की मीटिंग में कुछ और घोषणाएं हुई हैं, जिसमें मुख्यतः एक जो इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट है, जो कि पहले एलिजिबल क्रेडिट की 120% तक लिया जा सकता था, उसे सरकार ने घटाकर 110% कर दिया है। इस घोषणा से व्यापारियों पर हालांकि थोड़ा सा वित्तीय बोझ बढ़ेगा, उनके जो पूंजी की लागत है व्यापार में वो थोड़ी बढ़ जाएगी। इस तरह जो घोषणाएं हुई हैं ये मिली जुली हैं, कुछ व्यापारियों के लिए लाभकारी हैं, उनकी कंप्लायंसेस का बर्डन जो है उसमें कुछ रियायत मिलेगी, लेकिन ये जो एलिजिबल क्रेडिट्स की लिमिट कम की गई है उससे थोड़ा सा व्यापारियों पर वित्तीय बोझ भी बढ़ सकता है। जैसा कि एक खबरें चल रही थी कि इस मीटिंग में कर की दरों को भी रिव्यू किया जा सकता है, बढ़ाया जा सकता है, लेकिन सरकार ने उन सभी खबरों को निराधार साबित करते हुए कर की दरों में कोई परिवर्तन नहीं किया है। जीएसटी में जो लॉटरी है, प्रदेश अन्य विभिन्न प्रदेशों द्वारा अपनी लॉटरी स्कीम लॉटरियां चलाई जाती हैं, पहले उन पर अलग अलग कर की दरें लागू थी, लेकिन यूनैनिमसली उसको भी एक 28% की दर निश्चित कर दी गई है। तो इससे क्या होगा कि एक यूनिफॉर्म रेट ऑफ टैक्स लागू किया गया है इस पर, इसी पे ये मुख्यतः घोषणाएँ की गई हैं।
Party people, you know, putting the word of Congress Chief Finance Minister, but Punjab, Chhattisgarh and others raising the issue of compensation. How do you look at the entire view in its entirety?
Well, on the issue of the tradition, I just want to recollect And I'm very grateful to all the ministers who participated. It was fairly an extended debate on the topic. Every attempt was made to keep that set tradition alive. Every attempt was made to convince based on the opinion making in the House. But eventually, the council was reminded that the rules are love and the tradition is not part of the rule book. It was reminded to me that tradition was not part of the rule book and the rules is what should govern the running of the council. And therefore, after that, even after that, I had taken the sense of the house and being reminded that probably even sense of the house is not warranted, but rules have to be complied with. We went ahead with a decision to have a vote. So, it is not imposed by the council, it's not imposed by me as a chair, but it was on a request from one member. So, let's have that in context. And as regards the discussion on compensation, everyone did recognize the fact that one of the releases happened only a couple of days ago. Very well taken.
Ruchi.
Many states have said that perhaps by February there will not be enough money left to pay the states and they may also seek legal recourse. What was their view in the GST meeting? They were also said that there were no assurances made by the centre, despite you also saying that the centre is very well apprised to the compensation cess issue as well and releasing the funds. What is really lacking between the communication of the centre and the state?
Are you recasting everything that which was said inside the council and corroborating with what was saying said outside?
Now,
or
I just want to understand that where
that's fine. Your question wasn't framed like that, so I need to be clear before I answer you.
I just want to understand that where is the gap in communication?
There's no gap within the council. I don't know if it exists anywhere. In the council and in the Rajya Sabha, I have explained very in detail about how we remain committed to cooperative federalism and also to keep up, to honor the promises given on the GST.
Meghna.
Ma'am, the presentation was made by the Committee of Officials to augment revenue. There were a couple of options that were given and what the state items have said that this is not the right time. Probably this is a time of slowdown, so this is not the right time to increase the rates. So is there any given understanding that later once they...
No, I want to first of all recast that question so that all of us understand the context and the content of the presentation. It was an officers' committee which consists of centre and officials from the state also. They have just come up with one first shot of data since the time GST has been implemented till today, and based on different options of if the growth rate is this or if the growth rate is something else, how will it be? And gave a first picture. And the council and the ministers agreed that on this they have to mull over for some time and then come back. Also, there were suggestions that not just this, but some more data will have to be collected, analyzed, and then presented to the council all over again, such as on one particular example which one state took, edible oils. What would be the market post GST? Post rate reduction, has the market expanded, meaning as the tax base for that particular commodity expanded? And if after the reduction or of the rate, has it improved in terms of the consumption and then tax collection and so on? So that was one example which was taken by one of the state. Somebody else also wanted a complete compilation, if possible, of all those items for which rates were reduced. Post reduction, what has been the impact both in terms of tax incidence, tax base, and also revenue collection. They wanted that also to be provided so that the presentation, which was only a rough first cut, will be better enriched for them to think of what more should be done. So that was the second. So even as I'm saying all this, there were also one or two of them who did say, the ministers, saying, using technology, have we improved compliance? Using technology, have we been able to plug any gaps or any misuse? Are we able to track it all? So even that they wanted a report on. So the committee of officers, consisting of officers both from the center and states, have these three things to add on, three, which each of which will have more things under it, to add on, get report, and send it to the ministers as and when they are ready, so that this first presentation, which is a preliminary presentation, with no indirect or direct suggestion on rate increase or rate reduction, and the additional information that they've asked, all put together, in the next meeting, there will be a detailed discussion. So first thing first, this presentation of the committee of secretaries, officers, did not suggest directly or indirectly increase or decrease as a proposal. It was matter of fact presentation of data and data alone. And based on that, some projections on revenue collection and on compensation cess collection. And that's about it. I hope that's clear.
JBD Banquets lie hai, Incredible Marriage Palace, Rajgharana, and the finest banquet hall, Jyoti Garden. World-class catering, centrally air-conditioned, lush green lawns, state-of-the-art lightning.
A perfect venue for wedding, launching and parties. Rajgharana and Jyoti Garden at JBD Banquets Enterprise.
ऐसे ही लेटेस्ट खबरें पाने के लिए बेल आइकन को क्लिक कर हमारे चैनल को लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब करें। धन्यवाद।